So welcome and happy Saturday morning to the Shape Maryland Conference. I will be presenting the Unified Physical Education Program. And this is a resource program with a focus on the upper elementary grades. You know, I think I have to record this and I don't know how to record it. So I'm sorry, guys, that I'm not having the best.
Recording. I think it says recording up in the upper left-hand corner.
It does? Well, can someone
record it on my side?
Okay, it's recording. Okay.
Yep.
Okay, Mackenzie, thanks. Mm-hmm. Okay, so Mackenzie, do you know how to stop this from moving on its own, the slides? Like it just
it's just bringing that to you just to be to test your patience, I think.
Okay.
I don't know how. I've never seen that happen.
Me neither. I probably did something, but I'm just going to keep flipping back, and I'm very sorry about this. So I am Sue Snyder, and I have worked with Special Olympics of Maryland for 10 years through Unified High School Sports and the Young Athletes Program. I retired from Cecil County Public Schools last June after 46 years of teaching. I taught in the classroom. I taught grades first, third, and fourth for 25 years. And then I was fortunate to be teaching PE and adaptive PE for 21 years. I started working Special Olympics of Maryland this August as the Unified PE consultant. I am so thrilled to be part of this Special Olympics of Maryland because I want to share my experiences and offer my resources of why and how special needs students can and should be a part of the whole school and community. I am very excited about the Unified PE resource program at the elementary level and what it will become in all the schools for every student. I'm very excited about this. I can't wait to get things started. I have four schools that I am going to pilot, and I am extremely excited about it. Can't wait. So the social norms, which is on right now, make sure that your cameras are on and that you have muted your mic. And while I'm presenting, I will not be able to see you. However, you'll be able to see me, and my colleague Mackenzie from Young Athletes will be helping me with everything. Please write your questions in the chat box throughout my presentation, and Mackenzie will keep me informed on what is happening. Gosh. So this slide shows Maryland's history of Special Olympics. Special Olympics started in Maryland 50 years ago. Some of you are not anywhere near that, I'm sure. But it also, Special Olympics actually started in Chicago in 1968. And Special Olympics gives an opportunity for special needs people of all ages to show that they have ability. Not their disabilities, that they have abilities. This is an inclusion tile game, and it will help for us to think about the true meaning of diversity and inclusion. And this game is a way to begin a conversation with your students about inclusion and their feelings. We don't have time to do this, but at the very end, there is a website that will show you how to game. I did it when I did a workshop, and it's very awesome. It really makes you think, and it's great for teachers also to have this. So we're not going to spend time doing this, but I strongly suggest that you do this one. It's a great game for adults and for students. Uh, Okay, this shows you the lifespan of participation. It shows an overall picture of the opportunities that Special Olympics of Maryland offer for special needs folks, young and old. We start down there with the Young Athletes Program, which McKinsey has a great session on that coming up at 11 o'clock. I hope you stay around to listen to that. She's a great person in many, many ways and offers a lot of activities, lessons, and all different kinds of things for the young athletes in grades pre-K to second. I know in Cecil County, we have, every school has it. Also, we go up to the next piece of it, and it shows that the we have unified PE programs, which I'm working with in the state of Maryland. We have the unified sports programs, which are in middle school and high schools at this time in Maryland. And then, of course, we have the community-based unified sports for the young adults and the adults. So, what is the difference? So, let's look at the definition. The definition of inclusion is that a includes a small number of students with disabilities in a general PE class, similar to mainstreaming. And I know many of us already do that. And this is where, honestly, this is what for the past, what, three and a half months, I have been trying to understand what is the difference between inclusion and unified PE. So this is where it comes down to. Instruction is typically intentionally for the student without disabilities, and modifications are for the students with disabilities. And the peer helpers will assist the students who have severe motor and learning needs. So this, to me, is what inclusion, what we've been doing. So we're going to add a different program that can be set up many different ways that I'll go over soon. But the unified PE class has similar number of students with and without disabilities. The ratio can be 1:1 or 1:2, where the instruction is intentionally to provide opportunities for all students to enhance their physical skills in motor, cognitive, and emotional learning domains. Now, if you're me, you're probably trying to copy all this down so you can tell the difference. This, this is going to be recorded. You'll be able to look at this up to 6 months. So don't feel like you have to write everything down, because that's what I was doing. So just don't worry about it. Just try to take in the difference, because this is big, and this has taken me a while since I really wanted to understand what is the difference. So inclusion is when the disabled students are placed in the PE class with students who are not disabled, like I said, with just some modifications when it's needed. And then, of course, the unified, there's modifications for all students because they're working together as teammates. Now, this slide is showing the let's see if I click it. Oh, good. The picture came up, Mackenzie. Hooray. Okay. So the assumption is that everyone benefits from the same supports. This is an equal treatment. Okay. So you look at their supports. They're trying to watch the game. Everybody has the same size box. Okay. Everyone gets the support they need. So you can see how the shortest person now has the biggest box so they can see over the fence. And in this one, all three can see the game without supports or accommodations, because the equality has been addressed. So that's kind of putting the different things that we're looking for in the unified PE program. Okay, this one, this slide also talks about unified PE provides an opportunity for students with and without disabilities to come together through ongoing educational and physical activities. It is structured around national and state physical education standards and grade level outcomes. That was important to me. That was important to me because I know that we all need to do that. And they include gaining the knowledge and skills necessary to maintain a health enhancing level of fitness. It also supports the development of leadership. Leadership is a big part of this program also for all students to have, and it empowers all the students. That word should not be there faster. Students in an inclusive gymnasium and a school-wide environment. So we have inclusive teammates and instruction. Please just take a minute and read over that. Okay, we have expectations. Equity. Success is achieved when all students are fully engaged in meaningful activities, sharing equally and learning together. So we have a lot of leadership, like I said, that's going on during this class. It's a huge component of the program. Everyone has their own individual strengths to become a leader. It's a variety of opportunities for students with and without disabilities to build leadership skills to enhance their ability to lead in and out of the gymnasium. By focusing on each student's individual strengths and their strengths of all students working together, leadership can take many different forms in the class. And in this picture, this student is helping from Chesapeake City, is helping the other student to do the correct form of curl ups and giving them some verbal cues, which they have learned. Okay, so this is getting down to the nitty gritty. So we're looking at the composition and the options and best practices in the next four slides. So I have spent, before we go over these four slides, I've spent many hours about 3.5 months really trying to understand, trying to put this all into words. And so I have a full understanding of what this actually is because I've been to reading a lot of information, attending workshops, talking to different unified PE educators over the United States, especially in the states of South Carolina and New Jersey, where the elementary unified PE program started. And that's where I got a lot of my information. Did a lot of Zoom meetings, a lot of workshops, and these slides will explain the most successful ways of starting and setting up your unified PE program. And before we take a look at all these slides, how you want the unified PE program to fit in your school is up to you. Please know that. Each school is different with different needs and different expectations. I am open to any and all ideas or ways to make the unified program work at your school. We are flexible about starting up your unified PE program, especially because of number one, this year has been difficult for all teachers due to the virtual and hybrid learning models. I applaud all you guys. Awesome. You guys are doing a fantastic job. So I applaud all of you, and I thank you so very, very much for working so hard at what you're doing. Also, number two,
presentation through PowerPoint.
I think someone has their mic on. I'm hearing some background. Check your mics, please.
Are you the first time you venture out and try to do this?
Thank you. Number two, schedules have already been developed and are in motion. So you really can't necessarily put in a new class. So these are going to give you different options, different models that to consider. But if you come up with something else, we are more than happy to take a look at that. So here's one model at an actual unified PE class. So you would have a pullout class involving students who have IEPs and or have lower physical abilities and students who have higher physical abilities. They must apply and they must be approved by the parent, classroom teacher, and the PE teacher. The PE teacher and the classroom teachers will be looking and really looking at the students that they feel would benefit and in many ways, leadership-wise or physical-wise, to work in this program. This is an additional class which must be approved by your administration, as I know, and this usually is decided, at least in Cecil County, it's usually decided in the scheduling with the scheduling committee that meets in the spring of each year. So this is something, if you can't do it this year, maybe you'd like to do it for next year. So that's one way of doing it. Another way of having a unified PE program is a self-contained classroom. If you have classrooms in your school that is a communication class, a behavioral class, learning for independence class, or a school community-based program, during their PE class, when they go there, this is another time that you could be doing the unified PE program. And this is, again, where students who have the higher physical abilities must apply and be approved by the parent, classroom teachers, and the PE teachers. So the parent would be notified, and also an application could be done. I know some of the schools in South Carolina did not use an application, but New Jersey did. And so the application would be very simple, just allowing them to know that they'd be missing a 30-minute class possibly, and it would be once a week. So that's one way of doing that. Also, if you have an adaptive PE class that you're already having students in, I know that happens in Cecil County, you again would have those students apply and the parent, the classroom teacher, and the PE teacher would have to approve them missing part of their instruction. So that's something to think about too. The last one is called pull out class during the recess time. So this happens a lot in South Carolina. They actually they go to a specific class, a teacher that they know wants to do more for those students. And during this, let's say it's a third grade class. So the third grade class, Mrs. Smith, wants to help and do this program for these kids. And she has some students that really would benefit also from being in this class, whether it's for physical needs or whether it's for leadership. And so during the third grade recess time, they would go to this 30-minute class and have this unified PE program where they would do, the different activities, a lot of cooperative and team building activities. So those are the four ways that I have come up with that I feel is a good way of having the unified PE program. So your time allotment, 30 to 40 minutes per week. It could be 30, it could be 40, whatever works for you. Again, these are suggestions. These are not mandated. Okay. I want you to feel comfortable. This is not a mandated program. This is not something you have to do. These are things that we want to work on and try to get more inclusion, more whole school activities. The ratio is 1-to-1. So you have one teammate, and we're trying to call them teammates and not partners. We've talked about that in our team that we have throughout the state. We're trying to call them teammates because we feel like that is not putting them in a different class if we call them partners or it's very hard to come up with a name that is, I guess, acceptable. I don't even know if that's the correct word, but something that we feel that they are equal. So we call them teammates to teammates. So you can have 2 1-to-1 or 2-to-1, whatever works in your class. Again, this is all just suggestions. And due to the limited type of instruction and leadership roles and the inclusion, this class should be limited to about 15 students. I have done it at the high school level in Cecil County, and 15 seems to be about the max. In elementary, I mean, you might only have 5 kids in your school that are on IEPs, but there might be other kids that are not on IEPs, like the overweight kids that might need to come into this smaller class. So don't forget, Mackenzie is checking the chat box. So if you have any questions, just write her in, because I'm like talking a mile a minute. Okay, I still got pretty good time here. Okay. So, most U.S. schools are integrated, so students with disabilities are educated in the same school as those without disabilities. However, this does not mean that inclusion is occurring in every school. So to identify the students who will participate, students with special needs and identified with an IEP, or students who have difficulty in PE class due to low self-esteem and or have physical limitations such as overweight, which I said earlier. Identifying the students who participate, students who are willing to volunteer to become teammates to another student. And again, we use that word teammates. This is not a peer helper type thing, it's teammates. Teammates will be identified by the PE teacher and or the classroom teacher first. And then the students would be required to attend a presentation or discussion of disabilities and behaviors related to the unified PE class. I think that is very important. And I have done that in the past when I've worked with the Corollary Unified Sports at the high school. It's really helped. They really appreciate it, and they really do want to know more about the children with disabilities and behavior issues. And we need to treat them and let them know that they are part of this whole overall team and a class, and we want them to feel good about themselves. So 3, students and parents must consent to this program, and a letter can be composed and sent home with the student. Or like I said, in South Carolina, they just call up the parent and say your student has been chosen. But I feel an application would be better, especially in grades 3, 4, and 5. They're able to understand that a little bit more. And that's what my focus is on. So the first 1 or 2 days in the UPE class, you have icebreakers, and we have plenty of activities for that. And that helps to let the students get to know one another if they're from different grades. If you have a 5th graders that are going to come down and work with a 3rd grade class, that's kind of an icebreaker type of thing. So that's good to know. And then several days of instruction and skill development are provided so students can use their leadership skills and social skills in the UPE program. Okay, so students without disabilities are not meant to serve as helpers, like I said, or mentors, but are equitable classmates, and all students should be encouraged to use their unique skills to support one another. This is a leadership opportunity that you can do, just a suggestion. It's not something that is expected in this program, it's just a suggestion. I think it's Frederick County, Maryland, they do this in some of their elementary schools. It's called Positive Approach to Learning. And they pick like a captain for the day, and it's a different teammate with students that would be students with or without disabilities, or they could be a pair, a pal pair that work together. And they would be like a captain. Maybe they would, let's look on the next slide. Maybe they would be leaders of the class period. They might lead the warm-ups, offer the last word with the teacher huddle before dismissal. And they would demonstrate activities and drills. And if they're responsible enough, they could take attendance. Each week, they would identify bonding opportunities to take place within the week. So that's another idea, just another idea. Okay, so I can't see what my slide says, the title of it, so I'm just going along. Sharing the space is not inclusion. Inclusion is about building a community of learners. It is about sharing everything. The educators need to believe in the concept. So the educators see the abilities of all students as contributing to the whole class. The effect of teaching for students with disabilities is the same as affecting teaching for all students. I think that's important. Okay, teammates. During class, their teammates in the hallways, cafeteria, and their friends. So we have increased physical activity for all students, increased acceptance of individual differences, positive climate. These are the things that you're going to find that will happen with this unified program. A positive climate throughout the school, increased feeling of worth in the students with disabilities, and new friendships will develop. Oh my gosh, I saw a lot of friendships develop with the unified sports. Absolutely. This will actually change people's lives. Honestly, this will change people's lives for the better. I'm just so thrilled about this program. Okay, so right now, Mackenzie, we're going to take a look at that video that you're going to put in the chat. And here's how it's going to work. You're going to watch the video on your own. It's about 7 minutes long. And then when you finish the video, please let us know in the chat room so we know we have everybody back. But what I want you to look at is these students have different grades, different levels of ability. They are equal teammates. They will show leadership and both enjoy the movements that they're doing. Students are challenged one another and themselves, and students are being positive with one another. Okay, class, we're going to do some yoga poses today. And I need classmates, all of you, to get in teams of two. Each team will decide as a team and practice as a team which four yoga poses they want to present to the class. Go ahead and decide, talk to one another, let me hear you, and practice.
I think I should do the tuck stretch because I love cats. And also I think I should do the tuck and stretch.
I'll do the butterfly stretch and use the ASA. And I'll do the butterfly and I'll do...
This one.
Okay.
Do you want to go first?
Okay.
we're going to do the butterfly stretch first.
So now I am going to be the cat stretch.
Kind of sit up.
That was the cat stretch, but if you want a little challenge, like the butterfly stretch, I'll do that on the puppy stretch.
Next, we're going to do the windmill stretch.
Maybe put your arm like this.
Puppy stretch, and after I'm done that, I'll show you the trick. Keep your hands together.
Last one. And now for the trick that I was going to show you. So, if you want a little trick or challenge, you can always put your nose to your knee. And that was the challenge and the puppy stretch.
Wonderful. Okay, classmates, now you're ready to show the poses to your class. And we'll have some music to give a little atmosphere to the program. So this is the time that you need to be nice and positive. Help your classmates. Remember that you are equal partners. Whenever you're ready.
You need to hold it for 5 seconds and repeat 1 to 3 times. Rest for 3 seconds and do it again. Rest for 3 seconds and do it again. And that's the butterfly stretch.
I am going to do the puppy stretch, but you have to hold for 5 seconds straight and repeat 1 to 3 times.
Good job, Anya. Doing good.
Gonna put your nose to your knees, but if you want to make it extra challenging, for more than 5 seconds. I held it for 10 seconds. Now I'm going to do the wind.
Wait for 3 seconds.
Good job. Thank you.
Do it again.
And for the last one, I'm going to switch sides because this is my non-dominant. That was their pass.
And that was the windmill strike.
Okay, classmates, we're very happy that you showed and presented your yoga poses. You did an excellent job. I'm proud of both of you. And we thank you very much for presenting them to the class.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Students, I know some of you have them and some of you don't, but the class gets in teams of 2 or 4 students, and each team has a scooter and a rope, which is really cool. And on the gym floor, we have 2 mats, which are the sandbars, and we have the lily pads, the green poly spots, which are the lily pads, and the shark poly spots, which are the sharks, and the tires, old tires, which is the pollution. And as soon as you say the word go, the floor just turns into water. And no one can touch the water. And the object is to have the whole entire group cross the river to the other side of the gym, which is the land. And the groups must cooperate and communicate ways to achieve this goal. And if they touch the water, then they must return to the beginning and start again. It is so awesome to see the cooperation, the teamwork, the sharing with one another and encouraging one another, the positive words. It's really fun. I mean, it is fun to watch. Students will use their boats and ropes to help them get across, and they can stand on the pads and the tires, the pollution and the sandbars. This is a great lesson to do. If you haven't done it already, I strongly recommend it. There's also closure questions to ask. It also has focus for your 3rd grade, your 4th grade, your 5th grade, and also enrichment. I hope you also enjoyed the video. Those are my grandchildren, and I was able to get close enough so you could actually hear what they were talking about and encouraging one another and helping one another out and showing one another different poses. And they had a good time doing it. And one is in 7th grade and one is in 4th grade. So there's a different thing there. And what I liked about it is that both were showing leadership. They both were actually showing one another and encouraging one another. And that's what this program is all about. So we also have unified PE goals, which are the SHAPE national standards that you see on this slide. And I'm sure that if you're a PE teacher, you are full aware of these national standards. So I'm not going to go over them in detail, but just for you to know that we do have them in our lessons, and it's important. It's important for everybody to have. Also, we have research support. Research has provided us with information about the unified program, especially the pro-social skills that are developed throughout the program. And you can see that 87% of the students reported that they learned about helping others, learned how their emotions and attitudes can affect others. They learned to stand up for something that they believe in is right to do. The students felt that they were able to change their schools for the better. Students with and without disabilities remained in contact with students with disabilities who they met through these programs, Unified PE being one of them. And students generally regarded the experience they had with their with these experiences as a positive point in their lives. And as teachers, we all know how important that is. Now, this slide may show you some concerns that you may have, and these concerns will be addressed at each Unified PE class, and each will be specific to those needs. And if we look at the first one that talks about lack of structure, I don't know if when I went from the classroom to the PE class, there is a lot of non-structure things that's going on in PE rather when you compare it to the classroom. However, that's what PE is all about. So the structure will also be better as we go on with the leadership and as it grows. Lack of training for how to teach students with disabilities. This is where the teacher, oh my gosh, we were just thrown into teaching, you know, mainstreaming years ago. And it is a shock, but you do learn as you go and you have lots of resources, me, myself being one of them. And we can certainly work and help you with any type of disability that you have. We will definitely help you through that. You might have concerns with students without disabilities, not enjoying this experience. And that is why we want to choose those students. We want to have them apply. We want to make them feel comfortable. So that is part of the process. So hopefully that will not be a problem. And then number four, students with disabilities are not enjoying this experience. This is where you might need to have a group discussion and talk about their feelings. This is why having a small unified PE class is important. Having students with disabilities get injured. Okay, we're PE teachers. We know they get injured, okay? Everybody gets injured, not just the students with disabilities. So it happens, we deal with it. A lot of times the paraprofessionals will absolutely help us with the students with disabilities. They know the do's and don'ts. And also consider talking to your physical therapist, your occupational therapist, get some background on the students if you don't feel comfortable. Those are all things that I have done in the past and it's really helped. And students with disabilities are not able to do or understand what's being taught. And that's why we have the leadership and the teammates that work together. I think that's a big, big important piece of it all. And I feel good about that. So these are the also things that I feel are important. Please know we are flexible and that is the key to our program, being flexible. We're going to meet the needs of your school and your students. Important. This could be a new class or an existing class that you already have. Doesn't have to be new. The school year, we're in November. It doesn't have to be new. Student ratios and ability levels can be flexible. This is a well-rounded, we want a well-rounded unified PE class. This is not a helper program. This is a player. This is a player and everyone's a leader. Everyone's a player. Okay, this quote came from Lisa Smith, who was presented at the workshop that I attended in August. And I just want to read it because it really makes me feel good to know that we don't have just one way of doing things. Okay, there is no one way to do unified PE. It can happen in any school, big or small. It can be a standalone class or be put right into an existing class. It can look any way that is right for each school and community. And I really go by that. Okay, here we have resources. Resources that you should look at, okay? Resources, extremely important. The first one there is talking about the inclusion tile. The third one there is talking about Unified PE. Number six is talking about Minnesota, where the workshop was. That's awesome, okay? Also those others, take a look at it, please. You have this information because all this is being recorded. On this slide, take a look at SHAPE Maryland. Also look at SHAPE, I did say SHAPE Maryland, didn't I? And also that's number two, look at number five, the MAPEC. Oh my gosh, when I first started working, this program, this group of people all over the state, wonderful. And they're willing to share anything. I love that group. This gives you some virtual settings. If you want to look at any of these, this is the workshop that I went to. Hip hop. Oh, music. It's awesome. It is awesome. You click on these and it will bring it right up. Also, Box is also great. That was also a partnership of Special Olympics of Maryland. Hip hop is a special, is a partnership with Special Olympics of Maryland. I'm trying to run here because I know I'm looking at the time. Again, the more resources there, just help yourself to that. Fit 5 resource, awesome. It has cards, it has fitness videos, staying at home. School of Strength, great for these kids, great for these kids. We have a statewide whole school in engagement. It is during the, it's on Thursday, December the 10th, but it's for Inclusive School Week, which starts the 7th. Please, please take a look at that. It's a wonderful program, school-wide. And here we have a virtual challenge or just a fantastic information about fitness for your students. Please take a look at this. It's 7 to 8 minutes by Ben Vargas. He's the health and fitness manager for Special Olympics of Maryland. Ben is a cool guy with lots of ideas and fun fitness and fun health activities. I want to thank you for attending my session. This session will, the recording of this session will be available through Hoova app for the next 6 months. If you have any questions or concerns that I wasn't able to answer during my presentation, I can be reached right there. You can see it. Hopefully my session has provided you with some interest for the Unified PE program. Please be in touch with me. I would love, love, love to work with you guys all through the state, please. Also, prior to the next session, please help me and look at the sponsors and exhibitors and visit their booths. Be sure to look at the Special Olympics booth during this session also. I mean, between your sessions on the Cool Schools Plunge and Unified Champion Schools. Please, before your next session, take a moment to rate my session by answering the 8-question survey that can be found at the agenda in the agenda. Special Olympics and I take this survey seriously and we'll take a look at it to help us. Again, thank you for attending my session on Unified Physical Education. I look forward to working with you in the near future. Thank you all. I am 3 minutes over. Have a great, great Saturday.